In my experience over 3 years, it's never worth the hike. I hope you have insurance on all your devices. Next thing, all these things I tell you not to do, I have witnessed directly multiple times. All right? Don't stick your head out the window. Don't stick your feet out the window. I don't think we've got one, but don't stick the service dog out the window. Most importantly, don't stick the baby out the window, or let the toddler crawl from your lap halfway out the window. This is not a trolley bar. This is a light bar. Please don't grab it. This is the stop rope. If you pull it, it will cause the engineer to stop, and then we're going to start. Please don't jump from one seat across the aisle to the other. Please don't stand in your seat. Please don't stand on the back of your seat. And please don't stand on the back of two seats pretending you're surfing. Please don't touch anything behind you. Those are all safety equipment. They're all set up properly. I'll talk about them when we're going down the mountain. All right, enough of that. We're going to have fun, because every time you go up this mountain, it's different. It's never the same, even for me, any one of these people who work. Something's different. So if you've ridden up the mountain before, you'll know a little bit of what you're looking at. And for those of you who haven't, I'm going to tell you what you're looking at and what to look for and what you can anticipate.
Thank you.
This railroads have one purpose and one purpose only, its entire existence, and that's to bring people to the summit of Mount Washington and back safely. Now, the origins of this come about way back in the 1800s. Absolutely need to prevent the moose. The cop knows his permanent fares over there on the right. We don't tell him when he's blasted, that's up to you. Alright, back to Sylvester. So, you know, we came here to hike this mountain with this pastor. Yes, people are hiking a lot in these cookies, because there is already
went to Boston for education after he grew up some. Was a mechanical engineer by training, went out to Chicago, got into the meat packing business. And then he expanded into the grain business. And it was in this business that he really did that program and then amassed quite a fortune. But by 1858, he was back in New Hampshire in semi-retirement. And he went to visit with his doctor, where they prescribed to him 20 fresh air.
He went up on it and refers to this as the Rack Railroad. Now, this is all part of the rack and pinion system that he
described. Those axes. And those axes is where he attached the cogs. There's two on all steamer engines. There's three on the biodiesel. And those cogs are what control basically everything. They control how we go up the mountain and how we go down the mountain. So everything.
See the numbers on these clippers that stuck out, right? The clippers are called caps.
One of his businesses was in trouble, and he had to hire a lawyer and sue one of the business competitors and or suppliers, I can't remember which one, but he hired an Illinois attorney by the name of Abraham Lincoln. And Lincoln was successful in winning the lawsuit, but by the time everybody was tied up in one way or another in the real effort. But as soon as the war was over, we went right back into operation. simultaneously has a 37.41% climb. No other trestle in the world has that much climb and that much turn at the same time. Now, there's a building, that is the Red City Cloud Cut. That is a hiker's home.